其实我小时候我特别喜欢舞蹈，看那个《一帘幽梦》，那个绿萍她没有腿了，我当时想，天哪，如果我没有腿我真的不要活。
The story of dancer Liao Jie begins with the 2008 Wenchuan earthquake.
Actually, 刚开始掉到废墟里面的时候，我整个人还在一种非常惊愕的状态，强烈的恐惧占据了我所有的想法，但是紧接着就会觉得很痛，身体也很痛，我心里面也很痛。但是后来因为有我爸爸一直在外面的这种喊啊，就是真的是嗓子都喊破了，好像内心的责任感和这种斗志被激发了，就觉得我要为了我的父母不管怎么样都要活下来。
After 30 hours buried under rubble, Liao Jie was finally saved. She soon realized, however, that she had lost her legs.
我是自己签的手术同意书，我没有犹豫，就差点连生命都没有了。就有这么一个强烈的对比以后，好像会觉得这双腿是可以舍弃的，如果我还能换来活的机会。
Liao Jie's mother, then in Chengdu, made it to the hospital in Chongqing. No one around her could bear to tell her the truth.
她同学下来接我，她要是有一次腿截肢了，我当时就有点受不了，因为他也是说一只腿其实。然后我在外面就一直想平复自己的心情。然后他就说，哎呀你不要哭啊，那你当然要是不要掉眼泪，他说如果你掉眼泪的话要是可能更受不了。他说妈妈你不用担心，我会好起来的。
Such calamitous misfortune would have made many people give up, but not Liao Jie.Just months later, she was back on stage with the dance piece Inspire.
I'm a very strong person. Maybe in others' eyes, it's not good, it's not perfect, but that's others' business. I have to believe it's good, it's cute.我夏天穿凉鞋，就是我还给那个我的假肢脚趾头涂指甲油，还买了不同颜色。我会觉得如果我都不爱美了，我人生就真的没指望了。但我认为当我很臭美啊，早上描个眉化个妆，我出门那一整天精气神都是好的，我就能够去重建我的人生。
It was this strength of character that attracted the man who would become Liao Jie's husband, Charles Wang, a professional prosthetic technician.
我从一开始认识他的时候就常常看到他的眼睛里面 有一道光，会发光的眼睛，特别是在讲到未来的时候呢，眼睛是发光的，这一点非常吸引我。
只要我愿意做的是他愿意支持我去做，比如说我说我想要穿12厘米的高跟鞋，他就帮我挑。
In 2014, Liao Jie married Charles. She arranged every detail of the wedding, although Charles also had a bold idea.
他有一天突然就说，他说我想你帮我设置一个环节。我说什么环节？他说我想在婚礼上帮你穿假肢，帮你洗脚。我说不要吧，我说我结婚那天要美美的，所有人都看到我就是要穿假肢这个画面，我还是觉得不想。
也是这个画面在我脑海里面常常会出现的，对，就是在婚礼上我可以帮他擦脚洗脚，然后把假肢穿上。对，我不希望躲在这样的一个外表后面。我们的婚姻是真实的，我们来的亲朋好友希望他们看到一个真实的我们。
With the whole new life of love and mutual respect, Liao Jie is full of hope for the future. Being married to a prosthetic specialist, she has a variety of uncannily lifelike artificial legs. As always, Charles loves her for her courage.
以前我一直想啊，我要这样出去，那我肯定就是很不自在。我觉得我会， 但当我真的这么走出去的时候，我没有，我好像还挺自豪的。
After growing up overseas and graduating from America's Northwestern University with a master's degree in biology, Charles worked for a company that serves Paralympic athletes. From his experience, he knows that many amputees could benefit from lighter and more comfortable artificial limbs. The key to changing is their mindset.
既然要明显的话，不如把假肢做得非常个性化。所以在对假肢外观，或者说愿不愿意穿短裤跟短裙在外面，其实很多方面的这个理念跟认知，我相信是变得越来越开放啊，尤其是在年轻人。
我觉得拘着是一件很难受的事情，我无法面对自己的时候，我就会很介意别人怎么看我。但当我真的喜欢自己的时候，其实谁怎么看我，我已经不在意了。我觉得这才是自由。
In the 7 years since their marriage, Liao Zhe and Charles have been organizing various disability inclusion activities. In August 2019, they moved from Shanghai to Beijing, where they now provide rehabilitation services for amputees. An estimated 9.3 million people in China need assistive devices, including prostheses. Liao Zhe wants to share her inspiring experience.
我就是想让我所获得的这种自由，让其他的截肢的朋友都能得到。从我们这里，不管你坐轮椅来、拄着拐来，你能昂首挺胸地走出去，这就是我们的一个盼望。
Refusing to give up has enabled Liao Zhe to rebuild her life. In Shenzhen, 2,000 kilometers away, an entrepreneur is on his own road to rebirth.Shenzhen is a flourishing city of opportunity, with an estimated 1 in 10 people seeking their fortune in their own business. For Zhou Haohai, it's a busy but silent city.
You want to eat what you're eating? Yes.
你好，我的亲友，他就开始说非常有信心的，我们在说以前获得过很多大奖。
你这么产品，这么 IP， 没有知名度，未来是不可能有人买单的。
In 2010.Zhou Haohai left the design agency where he was working and came to Shenzhen with his product, the Iron Monkey. But there is always a gap between dreams and reality. Repeated refusals and doubt put him in a fog. Born into an ordinary family in Chedong Town, Guangdong Province in 1976, he has lived in a muted world since an accident damaged his hearing at the age of 4.
去医院看病的时候就给他打针，打了链霉素，医生就说是第八对脑神经中毒，是永久性的，真是晴天霹雳啊，就不知道怎么好。
Zhou Haohai's mother was devastated by her son's sudden and crushing misfortune. After his loss of hearing, however, the clever boy still showed interest in the outside world, especially a cartoon character.
He watched the movie《西游记》啊，对孙悟空就比较喜欢。
In daring to defy fate and fighting for the weak against the strong, the Monkey King had a great impact on the young boy. Here was the very definition of a hero and a role model for his life. In the 3 decades since, Zhou has been drawing and practicing animation to bring the fearless inner monkey to life. Cho pushed on with his dream in spite of repeated setbacks, eventually finding success with a short film, Dream, featuring the Iron Monkey. He did not expect this success to bring opportunities in its wake.
2013年的深圳南山区的这个创业之星大赛，当时我是评委，我记得当时还看了他一个短片，让我很感动，觉得这个聋人创业非常难，所以在评审的现场，我就当时就当场拍板说我可以投资他。
After 3 years of struggling, Chow Hao Hai was thrilled to receive his first angel investment of nearly 1 million yuan.Shortly after, he formed a team of some 20 people, including employees who were hearing impaired. To make progress, however, they had to overcome obstacles that would not be an issue for ordinary people.
投了以后你才会发现其实背后有很多的问题，就当时跟邱浩海跟整个团队的交流非常困难。我们每次开会的时候就是拿个手机在上面打字，特别慢，特别没有效率。
Both Chow Hao Hai and his investors realized that the difficulty of communicating with ordinary people was the biggest challenge facing the group. On their advice, he expanded the scope of his startup from developing his Iron Monkeys IP to a social app targeting the hearing impaired community designed to help them make their voices heard. Most people with hearing impairments communicate using sign language.Which few people with normal hearing can understand. After 3 years of effort, in 2016, the app called Deaf Life 1.0 was launched, connecting people who are deaf with the world using text-to-speech and speech-to-text technology.
他最认真的一件事就是要坚持下去，他比较执着，就是做一件事一定要把它做好。
Chow Hao Hai expects his Deaf Life to be not only for text and voice conversion, but also a social platform for more hearing impaired people like him to enjoy the convenience of technology.
你好，我是聋人，我要去会展中心。
Developing a new app often requires a big investment. The expense of doing so can put tremendous pressure on a business. During hard times, Chow Hao Hai considered selling his house to pay for his kids' education. He often blamed himself for not taking good care of his family. Many entrepreneurs find it hard to stay quiet and focused in a noisy world.But this is normal for Chow Hao Hai. After 5 years, Deaf Life has become a comprehensive platform for the hearing impaired to access social, medical, and employment services. Chow Hao Hai hopes his experience will inspire more people with disability to start their own businesses and integrate into society with confidence and equality.
其实我们现在的这个项目，我们希望它既能够是有公益的属性，同时要有商业价值，这样的话它才会持续的发展，让更多的残疾人、更多的聋人关注到这个创业，能够更多的去积极的面对自己的人生。
Chow Hao Hai makes his inner voice heard with silent persistence. For many like him, physical inadequacies are nothing to fear. The worst thing would be to lose their courage to challenge fate and keep smiling in their day-to-day struggle.
四季过多久才等来炎夏？等待 还来得及吗？如果可以回到起点。
The 31-year-old Wang Yi introduces herself in 3 sentences. I'm optimistic. I'm a young person with joys and sorrows. I'm a writer.
他14岁的时候就说我将来当一个作家，当时我们都认为他是天方夜谭。
我们跟他爸爸都根本就想不到，我说可能吗？他成为那个，他就想我将来做作家。
Wang Yi, born on the winter solstice of 1989 in Yangcheng, Jiangsu province, has never been able to speak or move normally because of cerebral palsy caused by birth hypoxia.
我们不动脑袋，我们当时两个人受不了，出门时候抱着他，也不晓得怎么迈出这个门，越这个门的。
For 10 years, the couple carried their daughter between Yancheng, Nanjing, Shanghai, and Beijing seeking treatment. There was no improvement in her physical state, but after learning there was nothing wrong with her brain development, the desperate family saw hope.
This one, you want to get out of here? Get out of here. No. No. You don't like it?喜欢针灸、粘处，嗯，就是不会走路。我们讲什么都清楚。我们出去看病，不管到哪就买的录音磁带啊、DP 啊、DVD 啊，有时候在电视上放放，给他看。反正是把不能就是跟人家同上一年级小孩不能落后，就跟着人家去。学知识跟不学知识是不一样的，晓得？我就是属于这种想法。
In 1999, the family moved to Nanjing.Most schools refused to take Wang Yi when they learned about her physical and verbal disabilities. After carrying their daughter to almost every primary school in the city, the couple finally got her a place.
爸爸希望你不要以泪水去博得别人的同情，而是你应该用自己的汗水赢得起别人的掌声。我说，优秀的灵魂无残疾，灵身体残疾，灵魂不残疾。
请听广播剧《忆爱情》，根据王毅同名短篇小说改编。
南京长江大桥，他们曾无数次牵手走过。某一天，思琪突发奇想，
哎，我们去一趟武汉吧，我想和你再去武汉的长江大桥上走一走。
这篇《忆爱情》短篇小说他创作于今年3月份，就是疫情最严重的时候。当时他看到说是南京的一对大学生情侣到武汉去旅游，然后生死相恋的这么一个新闻，他呢很感动，两天写成了一篇7000多字的短篇小说。
In pursuit of her dream of becoming a writer, Wang Yi has never stopped writing. From 9 in the evening into the morning of the following day, she is absorbed in operating a keyboard with her only controllable finger. She likens this to running a marathon on a single finger.
点亮一盏台灯，仿佛都是对熟睡者的惊扰。但有谁知道，此刻正是我灵感的破晓。今夜又想说些什么？大概只有指尖和键盘知晓。
他曾经写过这一段话：我在用一根手指在键盘上奔跑，我把我的键盘作为停机坪，把我的手指和我的思想作为翅膀，然后在我的用我的思想在我的脑海中支撑。
With one finger, Wang Yi, over the past decade, has typed out one novel, 3 collections of essays, and 4 collections of poems, totaling more than 1 million characters. In May 2020, she published her first autobiographical novel, Winter Fireworks.
这里面的主人公小东其实就是他自己，讲述了他自己童年时期在我们江苏苏北的一段特别的生活。你觉得这部小说里面你为什么想用一个焰火这个意象，它给你的人生有一个什么样的不同的意义？
因为
他说因为焰火比较美丽，但同时焰火也比较短暂。我觉得文学的魅力就在于此，它能够帮助我们去抓住那些令我们感动的飘忽不定的一些瞬间。
心怀梦想，像笔尖的莲花绽开。
There is an unyielding strength in Wang Yi's writing. This strength is rooted in her character and comes from the support of her family.
15岁以后我就放手了，给他去干了，比如那洗澡啊、穿衣啊、吃饭啊，我说不是妈妈心狠，你必须要去这做，哪怕你就是爬，你都爬了去。衣服你不爬，你哪怕穿一个小时、两个小时、三个小时，我让你把新衣服套起来。你要获得以后将来获得轻松愉快，那你就要学着自己去干这些事情。
新生的肉体会替代沉默多年的言语，就让什么都慢下来吧，让许多事都循序渐进，重新生长，至少长成你能听懂的模样。